Well, good evening, and welcome to Wednesday Night Ignite. We are so glad that you're here with us. Glad that you could join us, whether here in the sanctuary or on our Facebook live stream. It is an honor to be here with you tonight, just to come and gather and worship and spend some time this evening just praising God for who he is, for what he's done, and for all the things that we know he is going to be doing in this next year as we anticipate this new year, this new opportunity, this new beginning. You know, a lot of people had big, big, big hopes for 2020, and in the church community, you know, there's this whole New Year's rolls around, and man, what better opportunity we have. 2020, look at the vision for our church. And then COVID happened, and all of those visions began to blur and began to dim, and everybody is now thinking, do we dare think about 2021? Do we dare set a goal and set a vision for this year for God to move in our community, to move in our church? And I think we should, because I think God is capable of doing whatever he wants. And we just have to be faithful, because God is with us through the trials. God is with us through the craziness of COVID and the craziness of all what 2020 was. But this year, I think, as we're getting ready to sing here in a minute, I think we should ask God to multiply those blessings this year. I think we should ask God to multiply the opportunities for us to share his truth, his gospel. I think we should ask God to multiply our own faith, to not let us be deceived, to not let us be downtrodden and worried about the things that we cannot control, but to give him the glory and the praise and the honor in the midst of all that craziness, and to let our worship multiply as well. So there is an opportunity for us this year to set a goal. How can we multiply? How can we multiply our adoration of God? How can we multiply our worship of God? In what new ways can we step out of our comfort zone this year and step out of the box and just let God move in a new way? Let God do something new and let us be a new creation in him. So we're going to get started this evening. As always, Patty's going to open us in a word of prayer, and then we're going to jump right in.
You bet I will. Father God, today is a day like no other in history, and we're just going to lay it all down at your feet, Father. We just know that whatever it is that is before us is not bigger than you are. We thank you for being the God that you are, so gracious and kind and loving. And sometimes you allow things to happen, but sometimes it's in those moments that we finally realize we got to hit our knees. We got to raise our arms up, and we got to ask you all about it. Sometimes we feel hopeless in days like we've had today and maybe the next year to come. Who knows what that will bring? But God, you got a plan, and you love us enough to say, just trust me, have faith, and I will guide you through. So Father, tonight, even in the midst of some chaos and uncertainty and downtrodden hearts, we're going to lift your name up tonight, and we are just going to press into you and worship you all the more. Because we know the God who is in control. We know the God who was ready for his people. We know the God that never fails, now or ever. So, Father, we just thank you. We thank you that your mercies are made new every day and that you love us enough to continue to pursue us. So, in the midst of whatever's going on, we're just going to give it right back to you and say, here you go, Lord. These are your battles, not ours. Just let us be faithful. We thank you, Father. We praise you. We love you. We pray all this in your son's Jesus' name. Amen.
You love it like Grady and Diamond. Bursting inside us, we cannot contain. Your love will surely come find us like blazing wildfire, singing your name. Oh God of mercy, sweet love of mine, I have Blazing wildfire, singing your name, God of mercy, sweet love of mine, I have surrendered to your design. May this offering stretch across the sky. Across the skies, these hallelujahs be multiplied. These hallelujahs be multiplied.
You know what? What did you tell us not too long ago about the word Hallel? Is it Hallel?
Hallel.
So, hallelujah. We say it. We raise our hands. We, you know, but what does it actually mean, Ross?
Hallel is a loud shout of praise. It is a loud shout of praise.
So we're talking about multiplying our hallelujah. Yes. So multiplying our shouts of praise.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, so exactly. It's ongoing, it's never ending, and it's adding more every day.
May this offering stretch across the skies.
Yeah. So it actually means that we need to be more in tuned, and our eyes need to be more focused so that we can see the many blessings. I think we miss them.
Yes.
Do you agree? I think we miss them. And shame on us, because God supplies over and over again, and we never give him credit. So maybe that can be the cry of our heart this evening.
Yes.
Hallelujah, multiply him.
You can't multiply if you start with zero. Right?
Yeah, because you multiply by zero, you get
zero.
Nothing.
Exactly. So you gotta be praising to begin with to multiply those hallelujahs.
We got a ton of people on watching tonight. So even though we cannot see you, we're gonna hope that you are out there and that you are raising your hands. So if you hear me now and you're online with us, go ahead and shout a praise right here on Facebook. Let's do it. Let's continue.
Or in your living room. The neighbors might wonder what's going on, but it's okay.
You know what they could do? They could do a selfie and then send it here. We could all watch.
Have you seen the commercial with the clogging problem?
Yes. I still want to learn to clog.
we need a praising problem is what we need. We need the neighbors to like, what is going on upstairs? What are they doing? Is somebody getting murdered? No, they're praising God. They're shouting hallelujahs.
Well, this would be the time to do it. Amen.
Amen.
This would be the time.
Great are you, Lord. You're mighty in strength.
Woo!
You are faithful. You will ever be.
There's
some
now.
Of those praises.
We will praise you all of our days.
Why?
It's for your glory.
Come on.
creation. Shout to God, all creation. How awesome is the Lord Most High.
Come on, guys. He is good. Here we go.
Where you send us, God, we will go. You're the answer we want the world to know. We will trust you when you call our name. Where you lead us, follow all the way. So raise your hand, all your nation. Shout to God, all creation. How awesome is the Lord Most High. And we will praise you together, for now and forever. How awesome is the Lord Most High.
He is good.
And we'll sing hallelujah.
There's that word.
Hallelujah.
Give a shout of joy and praise.
How awesome is the Lord Most High.
Hallelujah. Come on, folks. Let's go.
And we'll sing hallelujah. Now and forever, how awesome is the Lord Most High. The Lord Most High.
Oh, I love our Facebook community. They started putting all these little hands up in the air.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, I love it.
See, I don't have the feet in front of me, so I can't see
them. Yeah, that's too bad. You just have to rely on me, don't you? That's always a problem. So can I share something really quick, because
sure.
I've been contemplating this, and we have no theme, if you will, tonight, but I have a feeling our theme is hallelujah and praise. First two songs were all about that already. But so I've been contemplating something, and you guys jump in if you feel led, but what I've been contemplating on is talking a little bit about or sharing, because I promised God that I would do this. I did. And I said, if you work a miracle in my life, I promise, I will turn around and I will give you full praise. I will not say it was luck. I will not say it was coincidental. I will not say anything but give credit where credit is due. So we talked a little bit last week about, COVID, and seems to be an ongoing issue. And I ended up having it, and a dear friend of mine ended up having it as well, and ended up in the hospital. And it's hard to talk about, because I feel like we were just on the cusp of her not making it, and we were, and I knew it. But she ended up in the hospital and just went downhill and ended up on a vent. And was really scared about that, basically because she's so close to me, and I wondered what we would do if she wasn't around. And and she wasn't very old. She's a little bit older than me, and that was hard to stomach, you know. I didn't end up there, and she did, and why was that? Anyway, she ended up on a vent, and on it for a couple weeks, 2.5 weeks, and then they removed the vent, and we thought, yay, out of the woods, we're going to get better, and then went downhill again, and I hit my knees at home when I heard when I heard what happened, I hit my knees and I said, God, you cannot let this happen. You cannot let this happen. You can't let this be the end. You just can't. And the problem was this. She went back downhill and the doctors told her, you know, we may have to put you back on the vent. And that's when she said, no, you will not put me back on the vent. I would rather take the alternative. And I had a really hard time with that because now we might be looking at, you know, the end. She's a believer, so really not the end, but the end with us. And I begged God, and I called on my Christian friends. I'm in a text group with some buddies, and said, you know, please pray with me because I don't know how else to turn or where else to turn. I need God, and I need him to do a miracle, and I know that's what's going to save us, and that's what's going to save her. And I'm telling you what, my praying friends are praying friends. They don't mess around. And these folks will go and they'll shut themselves in a room and they'll get to their knees or they'll find a quiet place where they can just have time. And I counted on that. And let me tell you what happened. My dear friend who was so ill, turned the corner and became much better within 2 days. And they moved her to step down. And since then, they've kicked her out of the hospital. And she said, I'm not going back. You know, but I promised God that I would tell the story as a miracle story. I know we talked about Daniel and Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Pastor talked about them on Sunday and the miracle of them stepping into the fire. And I thought, my friend was in the fire. You know, she was in the fire. And she may have been unable to pray for herself because she was in the condition she was in. But my praying friends, we all knew. And we got down to business. And I'm just so thankful. And it's just important that we give credit where credit is due. And when we talk about, you know, multiplying our hallelujahs, that's something to multiply your hallelujah about, you know. A life was saved. Do I believe she got better on her own? I believe she was given a medical staff to help take care of her. But heck no, I don't think it was anything less than a miracle. So we're going to continue on with our praise and worship service in a second. And we're going to talk just about how good God is, because he is a good God. And there's never a day he goes by and doesn't make our mercies new, because we are mess ups and we talk about that. But that's not the end for us. Christians know that God is so forgiving and he's loving and kind and he lets us do lots of do-overs. So I wanted to throw that out there because, first of all, I feel like I've been called to tell you that. And secondly, I promised I would. My promise isn't to these guys. My promise isn't to family. My promise is to him. And when he steps up and he does something and he wants us to share that, you need to step up and share that, because God alone gets the credit. And I don't know if anybody here has anything that they can add to, you know, the goodness of God and how he has stepped in to your life lately. But if there's something that you guys want to share, feel free to do that. And while they're thinking about it, if you want to share something on our feed, go right ahead. Plug it right in. We love to praise and we love to give God credit. And we love to share those stories with each other.
And if there's something you need prayer for, maybe you're the one who's in need, go ahead and put that on there too, and we will have our prayer team pray for you as well, because we know there's power in prayer.
What you said about, you know, God's mercy is being new every day. That was actually, I was looking up earlier today about God making us new. Like the Bible verses on being made new. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come, the old has gone, the new has come. Every day is a new day. Maybe I didn't do so great today. Tomorrow's a new day. Jesus, be with me and make me new. Make everything I do mean something to you. Colossians 3:9-11. Do not lie to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge in the image of its creator. Here there is no Gentile or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave or free, but Christ is all and is in all. Take off the old Get rid of 2020. Get rid of all the things that you might be not doing so well, and put on the new. Put on the armor of Christ. Make every day mean something for Him.
I love You, Lord. I know Your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in Your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing the goodness of God.
Oh, He is good and faithful all the time.
All my life You have been faithful. All my life You have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing the goodness of God. I love Your voice. You have led me through the fire. Darkest night, You are close like no other. I've known You as a father, I've known You as a friend, and I have lived the goodness of God. All my life You have been faithful. All my life You have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing the goodness of God.
Oh yeah, He is constantly running.
Your goodness is running out.
Have some prayer requests, and we want to encourage you to keep those coming in. We are a praying church. We believe in the power of prayer and that God will answer. We believe that He has called us as prayer warriors. We believe that He has asked you to lay those down in front of a prayer warrior to step in and intercede for you. So it doesn't even have to be a certain request. If you have an unspoken, throw it online so we can see that you have a need, and it will be covered. I swear to you, 'tis the truth, right, guys? We will make sure that your needs in prayer are covered. That's what we do here. So grateful that we are a church who believes that we have a listening God, and a God who can act, and a God who can solve, and a God who can love, and a God who can forgive. And we could go on and on and on, and then Ross would be mad because he won't get to start the next song, because that's just who God is, encompassing everything. So let us help you. But I would ask for one thing from us, that you pray for us as a team. You know, we're just normal people here trying to lead folks to a life of, with Christ. And there isn't anything special about any of us, I don't think, is there? Anybody got anything they want to shout out?
My hair is awesome.
Ross has no hair. That's what's special about Ross. I want to get him a mullet, but he used to have one. Right, Ross?
It was not a mullet.
Oh, it was. I have a picture. Oh, I heard out there. I knew it. If his wife is out there listening and you have a photo, can you please get it to me, Emily? I would love to have that photo. And Ross doesn't even have to know about it. Right, Brian? We can take care of this, can't we?
It'll be fantastic.
It would. I'm done.
Walking around these walls, oh, I thought by now they'd fall, but you never fail me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, for you never fail me yet. Your promise still stands, great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. Your love, oh, my heart will sing your praise again. promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. Never fail. Promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. Never failed me yet.
I know Richard Haseley is on tonight because I looked and he was going to be absent from church this evening. And I said, well, you better be online with us. And he said, I will be. And I looked. Guess what? He's faithful. He hasn't failed us either. Hi, Richard. So, actually, you know, just talking about Richard, I've talked about this before. He loves the song. You never failed me, you know. I've seen you move the mountains, and I know you're going to move them again. And in my life, I think that happened. You know, when the mountains are moved, it's important that you recognize it, the miracles that God presents to you, and then you share them.
Well, and then once you've seen it, yeah. You know. And then you start looking for it. So for those that haven't seen that mountain moved yet, for those that haven't seen that miracle in their own lives or somebody that they know, don't give up hope, because God is faithful. Like we just sang, God is faithful. And you just have to be faithful in your prayer and your petitioning to God and your faith. You have to be faithful in your own walk. And the Bible tells us all you have to have is the faith of a mustard seed. And we're like, well, that's dumb. Like, all of my miracles should have come true because I know I have faith of a mustard seed. But do we really, right? We're like, well, why isn't God hearing me? Or, well, maybe it's because you're not hearing God. Maybe it's because you're not really listening. Maybe you're just going through the motions. Maybe you're thinking that I have to do X, Y, and Z, and then God's going to hear me, and then my mountains are going to move, and then my life is going to be so much better. But here's the thing. You don't have to X, Y, and Z. You have to be faithful. You have to believe. You have to believe that Jesus died, was resurrected, and took your sins on the cross, and now you have salvation. You have to believe, because faith isn't earned. Faith isn't bought. Faith isn't a product of your works. It's not like you know, all right, well, I came for communion, and that's good, and I was baptized, so that was good. And now, look, I'm here. This is my third week in a row that I'm here at church. So maybe now the miracles will start happening, but in reality, are you in God's word every day? Are you reading his truth? Are you listening for him in that still small voice? Are you truly being faithful? Because God is. But like Patty said, once you see that mountain move, once you get that, and you're like, how did I not get this earlier? Like, how did I not see God's been working in my life this whole time? And then we look back and we see all the mountains that have been moved that we didn't even recognize. And then we look to the future, and sometimes the mountains don't seem as big. And sometimes the mountains aren't something that we can't overcome, because we know that God is right there with us the whole time. So Richard doesn't like the last part of that, never failed me yet, implying that God is going to fail us. God is not going to fail us. God is always faithful. And I think that once you've made that connection, once you see it with your own eyes, once you experience it in your own life, and I know Janice has shared stories of faithful prayer for decades, for family members, for friends, and after decades of faithful prayer and spending time in her prayer closet and just petitioning God to soften their hearts and to hear his truth, it happened. And so she was good. She's like, all right, I got my accomplishment done. I'm not going to pray. I'm good. No, she went right on to the next person and probably has a list that she prays for
like daily, weekly, you know, hourly even for some of us probably. She probably prays for me hourly, I would hope. But in reality, that's what faithfulness is. God is always faithful. So just a word of encouragement as we as we're getting ready to close tonight. We're going to close with an old hymn that's been added on to. And I like the addition that was added to this. And the song is Amazing Grace, and everybody knows Amazing Grace. And the chorus that was added on is real simple, and I'm sure you probably heard it because it's been out for years, but it says, "My chains are gone and I've been set free." Free from what? Well, free from sin, free from guilt, free from sorrow, free from all those things that are really trying to separate us from God.
How about worry? Worry. This is a good one for now. How about fear?
Yes.
How about when you don't feel like you're good enough?
Yeah. Yep. There are days. But our chains are gone. We've been set free. It says, my Savior has ransomed me. And that's what I was just talking about. Like a flood, His mercy rains. It's unending love and amazing grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Oh, I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious is that grace appear, the hour that I first. My God, my Savior, He's ransomed.
Again, we're so blessed that you were able to join us tonight. We would invite you to our Sunday services. We have a 9 a.m. service and an 11:15 service. We would love to have you come and to worship with us in person. Join us next Wednesday here in the sanctuary or online. But whatever you do, make sure you're setting aside time to get into God's Word. You're setting aside time to be in His presence, to just sit and listen for a while. But more importantly, to trust in the plan that He has for you. So tonight as we leave, we're going to close in a word of prayer. We're going to send you on your way. But know that you're never alone. God is walking right there with you through the fires. God is walking right there with you through the celebrations of life, through the joys, through the heartache. He never fails us. He never leaves us. He never forsakes us.
Father God, I know you were here tonight. I felt your presence. I felt your presence among the team, folks joining us online. God, we just don't have an option but to turn to you. And thank you sometimes that you put us in that position. Because sometimes that's the only way you get our attention. But Father, you are a good, good God. And you love us so much. You never stop pursuing us. Even when we wander away and we're gone for a while, gently calling us back like you would that one lost sheep in the flock. We just thank you, Father, that your love is never ending. And we thank you for the fact that our chains are gone when we know you. All the things that we do and say and the way we act, you somehow can take that away and give us new life. And you do it on a daily basis. Can't be any more thanks than that. Such a good, good Father. So, Lord, as we go about our day tonight and our week until we meet again, I ask that you open our eyes. Open our eyes so we can intentionally see those mountains being moved. Big or small, just open our eyes so that we know that you are working and that we can turn and give you praise. You're a good, good God. Thank you for all you are. Thank you for your Son, Jesus. We thank you for your love and blessings. It's in His name, your Son, Jesus, that we pray. Amen.
Amazing grace, unending love, amazing.